The real issue is, why did Romney lose? Well, the immediate answer is the storm. And in fact, I wrote a column I was just showing you 4 days before Election Day, entitled, In the Last Few
Hours... You mean Hurricane Sandy?
Yeah. In the Last Few Hours, Sudden Danger Signs in Polling, saying that Obama could be coming back because of the storm. The fact of the matter is that before Hurricane Sandy started, Obama was trailing Mitt Romney in Gallup, in Rasmussen, in virtually all of the major polling, because he had lost the first debate, not recovered it in the second, and gotten a little bit better in the third. And nobody could tell the impact of Sandy. 15% of the voters made up their minds in the last 72 hours. And they cited Sandy as number one.
But it wasn't just Sandy, because when the numbers finally came in for Obama, he just cleaned Romney's clock. I mean, he did. And unfortunately for you guys, it was a really bad beating in the end. It wasn't even close. It wasn't the nail-biter. It wasn't a surprise. Obama ran in the end of clearly a much better campaign. And you can't just honestly, Dick, blame a storm and say that swung it completely to Obama. Well, Obama was going to win without the storm.
Well, I prefer to believe that CNN's polling was accurate, wouldn't you?
Well, I think all the polls should be taken with a large pinch of salt.
I think that...
I really do, and I think that Nate Silver actually was the guy.
Yeah, but he doesn't work for CNN.
He doesn't, but we had him on, on this show three or four times in that period. And Nate Silver kept looking me in the eye and saying, all the pundits are wrong, all the polls are misleading, Obama's going to win this easily. And he was doing it from pure number crunching.
The question really is why Obama won by such a margin. And I think the answer is that there has been a fundamental demographic shift in the United States. And I thought that it had surfaced in 08 because of a charismatic candidate. Then I thought it would go back down again, and it did in 10. They didn't show up. But in 12, they showed up again in huge numbers, and 8 million whites stayed home. And I think the Republican Party has got to change in fundamental ways. Otherwise, it will never win another election.